Hey, what's up, you guys? I hope you're all doing well, and I hope you found everything you were looking for on Thursday. I gotta admit that New York Comic Con hunting was a little bit tougher than San Diego Comic Con hunting. I had to drive around a little bit more, and I think the stores were a little less organized and a little less well-stocked. I ran into a few angry hunters and some scalpers this time, obvious scalpers this time. Kind of annoying. Yeah, they were just annoying everybody with their shit. But yeah, let me show you what I got. I also found some stuff that wasn't New York Comic Con exclusive, but they were out when I was hunting, and I'm going to show you those first. When I saw images of Steampunk Batman online the other day, I thought it was just a really good custom, but no, he's real and he's at Hot Topic now. And they all had really good paint jobs, so if you like to order stuff online, you'll be pretty safe. But yeah, he looks really cool. I like the Steampunk style on Batman. I am not sure if this is actually from the comic books or it's just some random pop they made. Either way, he looks really cool. And yeah, glad they were there. If there ever wasn't a chance to do a brown box, it would have been for this Steampunk Batman. I think a brown or sepia toned box would have been way more appropriate. But yeah, purple looks cool. But yeah, I think that should have been brown. Also a Hot Topic exclusive, I picked up Ahsoka Tano. I had been looking forward to this pop for a long time. I think she is my favorite character that's actually not in the movies. Really cool character, really great design on her. And just like the Batman, this one has a really great paint job. So if you're going to order online, you'll be pretty safe. But yeah, look how colorful she looks. Really, really awesome pop. Really glad I finally have Ahsoka. And the last pop I picked up that isn't NYCC exclusive is Elvira, Mistress of the Dark. I'm really surprised they made this one, but I'm really happy they did. It's like perfect for a pop. I used to watch this movie all the time when I was like 12. I don't know why. I don't know why a 12-year-old boy would want to watch Elvira all the time. Maybe because she has a lot of chi-chi going on. Speaking of which, I think they should have made her boobs a little bit bigger on the actual pop, but you know, that's a small nitpick, if that's the correct word. But yeah, she looks really great. I'm really glad they gave her some lips. Yeah, this is an awesome pop. Glad to add this to my collection. The box art is really cool with the spider webs. Yeah, Elvira. This is one of the pops I wanted the most this year from NYCC, and that is Sally in the seated position with her little cat. I actually have the Jack with the vampire Teddy from last year's NYCC, so I think this is the perfect companion piece for that one. And she is a major improvement over the original Sally. I didn't like the original Sally, and I never bought her. She always just looked off to me, but this one looks great, and her scars are actually sculpted in on her body and her face. And the sculpt on her hair looks really nice, and the paint is perfect, and I love that she comes with a little black cat. This is a really, really awesome pop. And what's even better is that they're going to make this Harley Quinn demon, which is a really, really cool design. I have the mystery mini of it, and I'm sure it's going to look even better in a pop form. And I'm guessing this Snowman Jack is going to come out in December. So yeah, looking forward to getting those two. But yeah, really impressed by this Sally. And this Behemoth looks better in person than he did in the pictures. I still think his stitches are a little heavy-handed, but he looks cool, and I'm glad I was able to get him. Now, this is the pop that caused a little bit of a ruckus at the Hot Topic because they only got about 8 or 9 of these. There was a whole ton of Sallys. There was plenty of those to go around, but they only had about 8 or 9 of these, right? And there was this guy there with his mom, like obviously his mom, and he grabbed 3 of them. Handed them to his mom, grabbed another 3. I grabbed one real quick because I was like, dude, what the hell with this guy? I mean, I grabbed 2 of them because I wanted to, like, you know, compare to see which one had a better box and paint job and everything. And luckily, the one I grabbed did have a great paint job. And I put one back and I waited for that guy to leave. And I put one back and some other guy got it. But yeah, people were kind of annoyed because it's like, dude, you're buying 6 of them. Obviously, that's your mom. Like, don't be a jerk off, man. And people were like, dude, can I get one? He's just like, no, I was here first. Being a total jerk, you know? And it's like, really, man? You're that big of a Nightmare Before Christmas fan that you need 6 Behemoths when there's only 9 of them and there's like 15 people here? Yeah, kind of annoying. But I'm glad I was able to get them. Yeah, really cool. And they also had plenty of Batgirls. I think besides Sally, they had the most of Batgirl. And this one was pissing people off too, though, because the paint jobs on these ones were so bad. It's just like the other Batgirl they just made, the Burnside one. Luckily, I got one with a pretty decent paint job on the body and a decent one on the face. Although, if you look really close, you can tell that it needed another coat of flesh color because that is a black head. And her nose looks a little dark. It's hard to tell here because it's in the box. But in person, you can really tell that it needed another coat of flesh color paint. But this was like the best one. I really looked through all of them and this was the best one. Also, some of the boxes weren't exactly mint. Like you can see a little bit of crease here. And they were all like that. Not sure why. But yeah, some of them were just atrocious. Like the eyes way off of where they're supposed to be. The yellow just looked awful. And it also looked like it needed another couple of coats of the yellow because the black was coming through. So that was really annoying. And I feel a lot of people were passing up on this one because the paint jobs were just that bad that even though they wanted it, they couldn't bring themselves to buy a $15 pop with that bad of a paint job. But luckily I got a decent one. And she does look really cute. I love this sculpt. So yeah, lucky on that. Alright, so while I was at GameStop, one of my girls went to Barnes & Noble to try to pick up the Hawkgirl and the Joker with the burned face. They didn't have the Joker, so I am not sure if he's just going to be online or if they're just going to get him randomly sometime later in the week or what. But she was able to get a Hawkgirl, but only after complaining a little bit because she showed up right at 9, asked the guy, you know, hey, what about those NYCC pops, you know? And he literally told her, we only got about 5 of those Hawk Girls, and they're held for all the employees. Like, there was literally 5 employees, or maybe 1 employee that wanted all 5 or something, that had reserved these. Like, they never even put them on the floor because they go, oh, the employees are just going to buy them. I'm like, that's total bullshit. And, like, luckily, she isn't someone to just walk away. She kind of complained, wanted to talk to a manager, told her what was up. Manager went and grabbed her one. The box is a little bit dinged. Not sure how Barnes & Noble continues to have messed up boxes right away. It's hard to tell here, but yeah, it's a little bit bent in right here. Right here, it's not the best. It won't really stay shut. Maybe I can jimmy it a little bit, but yeah. Box isn't mint, and she kind of had to complain to get it. I mean, like, what balls on this guy to even tell the customer, like, oh yeah, we're reserving them for the employees. Like, what the hell? Just say you didn't get them, you know, if that's the case, like. But luckily, he was kind of dumb, said that, and my girl was like, no, fuck that, you know. But yeah, I don't even watch Legends of Tomorrow. I just wanted it because this is a really, really awesome sculpt, and I kind of want to get the Hawkman to go with her. I'm not going to get any of the other ones. And I mean, yeah, the Hawkman does look a lot like her. I mean, they look almost the same. And I don't know why they didn't give her a weapon. But yeah, I kind of do want to get the pair, and I do want to see this show, like, if it ever comes on Netflix or something, I'll watch it. But yeah, really cool. But yeah, kind of weird that they only got 5 and people had to kind of complain. I then moved to GameStop, and that was another bit of a fiasco because me and 3 other dudes were there first, like, clearly first. We were there like 15 minutes before the open. We're just talking, hanging out, and the manager opened up the gate and just let us know, like, look. Like, we didn't get any pops from NYCC, so we're going to check the computers, see if we are going to get them today or what. Comes back about 10 minutes later and lets us know, like, look, we only have 4 of each, only 4 Kitty Prides and the rest. And by then, a few other people had showed up, and of course, they were like, oh, well, I was here, and we clearly went, like, dude, we were here first, and the manager luckily remembered which 4 of us were there first, took our names down, and wrote down which pops we wanted. Of course, everybody wanted all 4. I probably could have grabbed the Super Saiyan Trunks because I knew I could have traded it with somebody, or I knew I could have done a giveaway. I knew somebody that I know would want that one, but I decided to pass it on to, like, somebody else. Like, okay, you guys go ahead. I just want 3 of them. But there was a few upset people, and I don't know. People are such douchebags when it comes to, like, just lying, you know. I mean, they're toys, yeah, okay, but we were clearly there first, and people were just like, no, that's not fair. I'm like, how is it not fair? We were here first, and the manager saw us, like, tough titties, you know. And One of my girls actually went to a different GameStop too, and she told me that they had Super Saiyan Trunks right when they opened, but none of these. So yeah, luckily the manager did remember to call me, and I was able to pick up this Kitty Pryde. She looks really cool. I remember the Lockheed in the glam shot to me looked like it was almost translucent, and this looks way better. It looks really nice. It actually has, looks like at least three colors on it, and the paint job on the Kitty Pryde is pretty clean. Luckily. Yeah, she looks cute. She's just cute little pop. Looks just like Kitty Pryde. But this is the nuts back here. I'm really glad they made Psylocke and Archangel. I am totally looking forward to those two. Same with the Storm. I mean, all of these, really. These are all really cool. But of course, just like everybody else, I still want Nightcrawler. I want Rogue. I want Gambit. Hopefully, they bring those out soon. I mean, I can't imagine that they're not. But yeah, really, really need those pops. But yeah, this is a great start, though. And Kitty Pryde, really awesome. One of the coolest pops of the day is the Joker from The Killing Joke, arguably the best Joker story ever told. And this pop does not disappoint, lives right up to those glams that looked so cool. The glass actually looks like it has a beverage in it. The paint job is flawless. Really, really happy with this pop. Yeah, and I like that they have artwork from the actual comic book on the back. I love when they do that. I wish they did that with everything. Yeah, this pop really lives up to expectations. Looks like they sent this one to the Good Factory, not like the Batgirl. But yeah, really awesome to get the Killing Joke. I actually was able to pick up two of these. One of my girls went to a different GameStop while I went to another one. And yeah, got one for a friend. Yeah, really happy I got this guy. And I hate to say that the most disappointing pop of the day for me is the Rainbow Batman. When I first talked about the NYCC exclusives and I showed the glam shot of the Rainbow Batman, I thought it was really beautiful and it was one of the ones I wanted the most, but I did have a feeling that the pop itself wasn't going to live up to it. It reminded me of the patriotic Snoopy that they put out during SDCC with that Star Spangled Banner paint job on it. The glam shots were really nice, but the actual execution of those stripes on the actual pops were so sloppy and so just weird looking that it made the pop unbuyable for me, and I just passed on it altogether, even though it was a cool idea. And this one was the best one they had there, but there was so many issues with it. Like, a lot of them had these weird chips on the same part of the nose. Like, all the other ones had it except for this one, but that was really strange. And if you look close, those eyes are way off with that red outline around them. And I don't think it was designed that way because it looks like a flaw. It looks like that white should have gone all the way around to the colors because it does on the glam shot. And also, right up here, it's hard to tell right here, but on a lot of them, the alignment was way off. Like, if you look at where his cowl dips down underneath his neck there, you see how the green and the purple and all the other colors aren't lined up right? A lot of them had that same issue going on up here, and it's right, like, right on the forehead. So it looked really, really bad. And the stripes don't go all the way down over here either. They kind of stop right here. So you see this gap of red right there? And that is just a poor design choice to me too. But this pop is unique enough and colorful enough, and I think it will look great with all the other Batmans because I really do like these repaints of the original Batmans. And this one is just so unique that even though the paint jobs are bad, and not as bad on this one actually, because on mine it does kind of line up pretty well here, and the eyes don't bother me that much, even though I do think they could have been done better, I still got it because of the uniqueness factor of it. Alright guys, let me know what you picked up today, what your favorite pops were, if you had any trouble finding the stuff you wanted to find. Thanks for watching my haul, and I hope you guys have a great weekend. Take it easy.